Hello and welcome to Quick Tips, the WordPress tutorial series. In the last video, we learned about how to set up the home page in the WordPress website. We also changed the default front page of the WordPress website to a static home page. Okay, now in this video, we will learn about the page builder plugins that you can use in WordPress website. Now, the WordPress does come with a built-in page builder. However, it has many limitations, and if you want to make more changes to your website, if you want to design new layout for your web page, then I'll suggest you to go for the third-party page builder plugins. Okay, so we will discuss about the built-in page builder that is also called as Gutenberg in the WordPress, and apart from that, we will learn about the other two page builder plugins that we are going to use in this video. First one is Elementor page builder plugin, and the second one will be Visual Composer. Now, both the plugins are free plugins, and both the plugins have many features, and I'm sure that you will like to work with these free page builder plugins. Okay, so let's start with the built-in page builder that comes with the WordPress.
Those who are watching my videos for the first time, check out the playlist on my YouTube channel. You will find free YouTube video courses. Subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon so that you will get instant notification whenever I publish new free YouTube video course or new video tutorial.
Okay, here I have the homepage. Let me show you how to edit using the built-in page builder. Okay, so this is the basic homepage. Okay, this is the text that I have here. Now, if you want to add any section, click on, you will see a plus sign here to add a block. Okay, remember this Gutenberg has the block system, so whenever you want to make changes, it will give you an option to add a new block. So if you click on it, it will give you the option to choose the blocks. Okay, now click on it, you will see all the blocks that comes with the built-in page builder. Now here is the list: paragraph, heading, list, classic, quote, code, quote, full quote, table, verse. Now these are the blocks that you can add to the page layout. Okay, image, gallery, audio, cover, video. If you want to embed video, such as YouTube video, you can simply click on it and it will give you an option. You can upload video. If you have YouTube video, you can insert the link here. So this is how you can embed the video. Now let me show you the other options. These are the media blocks. Now this is the button, columns. If you want to add columns to the website, you can click on it. Okay, now here you will see the options. You can select the column, one column, two column. Now this is 30-70, 70-30, three columns. And this is also a three column system. So let me show you if we will select this one. Okay, so it has created two columns here. In this column, we can add one more block. Let's see this one. And here we can add text. This is a text block. Okay, now in this block, you can add another block. Let's add an image here. Let's upload one of the images and see. Okay, so it will show the image here. Now let's update it and refresh the page. Now you will see this block is here and this block is here. So this is how you can edit the page and add more blocks to your web page. Let's see another blocks, buttons. Let's add a button. Okay, this is a, or let's say, let's make it a click here. Okay, now this is the background. If you want to customize this block, you can go here, and here you will see the option advanced, fill the color. Color settings are here, you can change the color. Let's choose this. This is the text color. Now see this one, let's change the color here. Okay, so this is how you can change the color. You can enter the link here also. Let's have, see, this is how you can add the link to the button. So let's see, let's update this one and see how does this look. Okay, here you will see the block, the button block is here. Let's see other blocks. Let's delete this one. If you want to remove this, you can simply click on this icon and remove the block. Okay, now click on it and see other blocks. media that is done. Buttons, group, page break, more space. If you want to add space, you can add the spacer here. Short code, sometimes you can add the short code from widgets or plugins. Calendar is here. You can also add, I guess, a table is also there. Custom HTML. If you want to add HTML codes, you can use this block. Okay, these are the embeds. You can add social media, YouTube. Okay, so this is how you can use this built-in page builder that comes with the WordPress. But I'll show you the other plugins, the free plugins that you can use to make your website more beautiful. Okay, so let's start with the first plugin. Go to plugins, click on add new, and look for Elementor, E-L-E-M-E-N-T-O-R. Okay, you will see this Elementor website builder. Install it. All right, now activate it. Okay, so we have got this plugin installed and activated. Now let's leave this page and close this one and refresh this page. Okay, now this is the home page that we were working on. Now let's use this one, home 2. We will create a new page here. Okay, now it will show default template, change it to Elementor full width and click update. Okay, and now we want to use Elementor to edit this page, so click on edit with Elementor. Now this is just a demo website that I'm working on, so do not worry about this header and footer section of this website. Okay, now what we have got this section to change the layout of your page. Okay, now here you can click on the plus sign and you will see different blocks or different layouts that you can use for this particular section of your website or the web page. So let's select this one. Okay, so we have got two column section here. Now the best part is that we can change the background of this section also. So if you go here and change, let's change the style of this page. This is the background that you can choose. Okay, now you can add some padding here, padding to the top and bottom. Now these are the two sections, two blocks where you can add different widgets. Now let's see, we will add. Now what we want the text on this page to be white. Okay, so what we'll do now, we will add text editor here. Let's add some text here. Okay, we want to change the text color here, so click on it, style. We can change the text color to white. Now this is the block where we are going to enter the images. So insert the image option here and select the same image here. Okay, so we have got image here. Let's update it and go to view page. Okay, so you can see the difference between the two pages that we created. The first one we created with the default page builder and the second one with the Elementor plugin. This plugin has many features and you can literally change any part of this web page. You can make it whatever you want. You can change the layout of this particular page to any premium theme also. And in the coming videos, I'll show you how to use this Elementor plugin. All right, now if you want to add more section, you can go to this plus sign and add more sections here. Let's change the background. Let's change it to blue. Okay, add some padding here. Now this is just the introduction to this plugin and I'm going to add more videos on how to use these plugins also. Okay, so I'm going to add this text here. Okay, let's change the color. Now if you want, you can simply right click on it and duplicate it. It will duplicate the text. Now right click, duplicate, and just put it here, update it. Now let's go back and refresh this page. Now you will see this three column section also. All right, so this is how you can go on editing your website or the web page. And this plugin also comes with the header and footer plugin, and that will help you create beautiful header and footer for your website also. And this is all free. Okay, so you can use many sections of this plugin free. You can see the other features in a section: text editor, divider, map, Google map. Okay, these are the pro features, so you won't be able to use it with the free, but there are many other free features also. Image box, icon, slider, you can create sliders also. Gallery is also there. Icon list, progress bar, social media icon. All right, so this is how this plugin works. So in the coming videos you will get detailed information about this Elementor plugin also. Okay, now the third plugin is the visual composers. Now let's go to Google and search for visual composer. You can go to their website. All right, and you will see the free download here. Click on free download. Okay, now it will ask you to enter the domain. You don't need it. You can simply download the zip and save it on your computer. Okay, it is downloaded. Now go back to plugins, go to add new, okay, and click on upload plugin. Now you will see the browse button. Click on browse and browse the plugin. Click install now, activate it. Okay, so it's done. Okay, now let's go back to the pages. Now we will use this one. Okay, now you will see two options there: edit with Elementor or Visual Composer. So what we are going to do, we will disable the Elementor for now. Now click refresh. Okay, now edit with a Visual Composer. Now this is also just the introduction to this plugin, and in the coming videos I'll show you how to use this plugin in detail. Okay, so similar to the Elementor, you will see the layout for the section. So let's use the same layout, two column layout. This is the first column, this is the second column. Click on the plus sign and add the element here. You will see different elements here. Basic, yeah, these are the buttons, video, features. So there are many free elements that you can use. This is the HTML that you can enter. A text block, let's add the text block here. Okay, so leave it as it is. Click on this one and add the image. If you want, you can search here also, image, single image, drag and drop it here. Okay, it has already got the image here. Okay, let's update it and see how does this look. Okay, so this is how the page look. Okay, now we will make some changes to this one. Now if you want to change the column, you can go to column and edit the column. Okay, you can go to this column, or you can simply edit the entire section here. Okay, this is the section. If you want, you can change the background color. Let's change it to this one. Okay, you will see many options are here for this plugin also. Well, let's save it and refresh it. Let's see how does this look like. Okay, so this is how this look. You can change the layout from here also, or use this one. You can drag it from here to here. Let's change. If you want to add more sections, you can simply click on this icon and add the more section to the web page. So this is how you can use different web page builder to design your website pages. In this video we discussed about three page builders. The first one is the built-in Gutenberg page builder, the second one is Elementor plugin, and the third one is Visual Composer. In all these three, I really like to work with the Elementor plugin because it has many features and it is very flexible. You can make entire website using this single plugin also. So that's it for now. See you in the next video. Thanks for watching.
Do not forget to subscribe to my channel to get more quick tips about online softwares and tools. If you have any questions, please leave us message in comments section. And press the like button if you like the video. Thanks for watching Quick Tips.